There were, oh, I don't remember how many blocks, 40, 45 blocks, 800 women in each one. And they were all numbered. And we wound up, I don't remember which one of them. And our daily routine, every morning at 4 o'clock, they used to wake us to line up for counting. We had to be counted. Then every day there were selections. They had to have their quota for. And we didn't know this. We were so naive at the time, we didn't know. But for some reason, my older sister Esther knew that we didn't stand a chance if we go into a Wählung, a selection. So she used to always avoid, as I told you before. If they were going to select 14 and we happened to be in 14, she used to run. She used to drag us to 11. And we'd stay in 11. For some reason, we were able to do this. Then she'd find this is going on every day. And in between, if we stayed in 11, again, 4 o'clock morning, wake up in the morning, have to line up. If their count didn't work, for some reason they made a mistake, we kneeled for the rest of the day. The food. A bowl of soup for the day. A square of bread. Me being short and young, and my sister Frances being short and young, we had a thing going that when they carried the soup, we used to run from behind. What we had in our hands, I don't know, and scoop up some soup. Excuse me. My poor sister Frances fell, split her knee open. The whole time, limping. I got caught one day. And they got hold of me. They threw me up in the air. My sister Rosie said, do it to me. I told her to do it. She's too young. They wouldn't listen to her. They threw me on the block where they take the kids away at night. My older sister Esther got me out of there. I didn't know what was going on. I had no idea. They used to throw the kids in that camp. At night, they'd come with a truck and take them away and burn them the next day. I had no idea, but my sister Esther, she was a tyrant. I owed my life to her. Twice she got